Hi, I'm Julia Bondage with River City Roller Girls, and this is my dog, Tori. You're watching WFTDA.TV.
With all the practice, work, fight, sweat, tears, to achieve the next level, it takes a team. Rose City's Wheels of Justice present Derby Days, a badass boot camp. 3 days of skills, drills, and scrimmages coached by Portland's all-stars and special guest. The Wheels of Justice Derby Days. Registration opens June 1st.
I switched to the Falcon Plus plate, which is a 16-degree angle.
The fact that you can adjust so many different aspects of the plate really means that I can adjust it to my skating style.
I feel like the plate is giving me that extra agility, but at the same time I'm not losing any energy in my push.
Since moving to the 16 degree, I've felt that I've got so much power and the action is so much quicker.
I've been skating on them for about 4 months now, and my edge work has improved, my control has improved.
Prior to this, I found that the plates were very obvious on my feet and I knew that I was wearing skates, whereas now they all feel part of my leg, like they've just grown on there.
Good afternoon, my name is Plastic Patrick. I'm here with Gretchen the Axe, and you're watching East Coast Derby Extravaganza from Feasterville, Pennsylvania, brought to you by the Philly Roller Girls and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. What we're about to see on track two is the Blue Ridge All-Stars coming to you from Asheville, North Carolina, ranked 41st in the WFTDA, taking on the Brandywine Belligerents from Downingtown, Pennsylvania, ranked 49th in the WFTDA. So, Gretchen, why don't we get to the team rosters?
Well, that sounds like a great idea, Patrick. Both Division II teams here. Mm-hmm. For Brandywine, taking the track today, we have number 101, Rapid Arrhythmia, number 121, Crash Banshee-Coot, number 138, Buenos DS, number 20, Starbucks, number 23, Thresher, number 273, Not Naughty, number 6, Dirty Roxtini, number 619, Party Crasher, number 69, Emma Degenerate, number 757, Cutthroat Casey, number 789, Deck Her Hater, and number 9, Skinny Guinea. The Belligerents are coached by Hot Wheels, with Cynical taking the reins as bench coach.
And wearing the black for this game will be the Blue Ridge Roller Girls All-Stars. The roster is a 00 Brutal, 033 Tricky Nikki, number 10 Ash Villain, 1081 Dixie Kicks, 11 is One Hit Wound Her, 160 Little Mermadness, number 17 Sugar Magmolia, number 27 Chief Goober, 315 Coma Inducer, number 36 Boot Scootin' Bully, number 5 Lady Rider, number 505 Distressa, number 75, Polly Slammerass, number 84, She Rex. And they are coached by Gabriel Little Bit. Adeline is the bench manager. How about these officials, Gretchen? We've got head referee Helen Bayoni, Inside Pack Ref, Rule Enforcer, Jammer Ref, Testosterone, Jeremy, the other Jammer referee, Dire Wolf. Outside Pack Refs will be Izzy Crisis, DJ Jazzy Ref, Danger Muffin, and the alternate Suki Tawdry.
And we are almost getting ready to go, Patrick. Blue Ridge taking a quick speed lap. This, as you said, it's a 41 versus a 49. Mm-hmm. And big game for both of these teams. I talked with Gabriel beforehand, coach of the Blue Ridge All-Stars. They want Division One. They won it this year. Oh, they respect close. Division Two. They came in third in Division Two last year. But they want the Hydra. They would love to be able to pump themselves up in the rankings here this weekend enough to be able to do it. On the other hand, Brandywine holding on to 49. They're not afraid to play anyone. They've had two games this past week. One versus Helsinki and one versus Victoria. And I spoke with Coach Hot Wheels. She said, we learned so much from both of those games that we're glad we played them. We know that they could have potential rankings ramifications, but we want to learn, we want to get better, and that's how you do it, is you play the strong teams.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think where they are ranked now, I think they're just looking to the future. This may not necessarily pump them up so much in the rankings for now, but what they will learn, they will take on to the rest of this season and to next season. And then when it's really time to pump up the rankings, that's when you really strategically plan your year to climb in the rankings. But for now, I think they are content with learning as much as they can and playing.
Brandywine, a relative newcomer to the WFTDA, and they skyrocketed in the rankings very early on.
Yeah.
They've been a WFTDA team for approximately 3 years. On the other hand, Blue Ridge, one of the originals. You know, as we said in the when we were talking before, Asheville's kind of the Austin of North Carolina, and they've been playing roller derby in Asheville a long time. Looks like we're getting ready to go, Patrick.
That's right. We'll have Lady Rider number 5 of 4 Blue Ridge jamming and Not Naughty for Brandywine taking the jammer line to start the bout.
And the hand goes up. We are off. This is a important game. So much so for both, but
yeah, there goes number 5 Lady Rider taking on the outside, picking up lead jammer status. Not Naughty gets pushed to the inside, and she picks up a penalty.
That's going to be
a track cut.
That's going to be a tough nut for Brandywine to crack. They are down one skater, Patrick. Anya All Night suffering a serious injury against Victoria just a couple of nights ago.
And now Blue Ridge jammer Lady Rider going to for her second scoring run. Shit, they're giving her trouble at the front of the pack, number 7, 8, 9.
That's Decker Hater taking up some time off the clock.
Yeah, but she does come through. That's 10 points so far for Blue Ridge. And right in there, she jumps in. No, you can do that now. You can actually plow into the walls without worrying so much at back blocks.
Back on the track now, we've got Not Naughty fighting through on turn 3.
She's still looking to perform her initial pass. They push her to the inside. She's got to recycle at the back.
Meanwhile,
Lady Rider still recycled on the outside. She's casually skating to the pack.
Another track cut called on Not Naughty. And with a small roster today, that's something that Brandywine's going to have to watch out for, is the penalties.
Yeah, but perhaps she just needs to get the kinks out. It is early. It's the first game at ECDX. They've been playing a lot. Here goes Lady Rider again for another scoring run. Number 3, they're not making it easy on her. Number 6, seriously recycling her, Dirty Roxtini.
Yes, Dirty Roxtini, don't let her size fool you, Patrick. She is a beast wearing the pivot stripe for Brandywine.
And here comes the jammer for Blue Ridge again. Lady Rider, let's hope that for her that this initial pass will be complete. No, jammer. Jam is timed out. And tough start for Blue Ridge.
That's correct, Patrick. And probably the most important statistic there is the two quick penalties on Not Naughty, two track cuts. She's going to have to clean that up in a hurry.
And showing up at the Blue Ridge on the jammer line for Blue Ridge is She Rex. And will be Crash a Banshee Coot for Brandywine. Jammers are off. Again, Blue Ridge in the black, Brandywine in the white.
The notorious R.E.D. penalty box currently empty, Patrick.
Crash Banshee Coot recycled to the outside. Boat Jammers recycled, but it is She Rex going to the front, recycled again.
Pack advantage for Blue Ridge as Decorator is going to be sent to the box. Excuse me, that was Emma Degenerate going to the notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
And Boat Jammers are out, and there is no lead jammer. Oh, there is a lead jammer, and it's the black jammer, She Rex.
Both engaging the pack on a scoring pass.
Yeah, and She Rex calls it off. Does she pick up any points? 1 point. Whew.
One for Brandywine.
Point. Yeah.
Nice work, nice second effort there. Brandywine's going to have to keep coming strong. If you have anything that you would like to tell us as you're watching these wonderful bouts this weekend, give us a shout out at hashtag talk2WFTDA, and we would be happy to respond if we can.
Coming up on the jammer line, we have Sugar Magnolia for Blue Ridge, and we'll have Buenos Dias for the Brandywine Roller Girls.
Currently an official timeout called on the track, and we have our first tweet, Patrick.
Yes.
This is coming from Glenn Herr. The Carolina Roller Girls and the Collisions Men's Derby are at home rooting for our cross-state sisters, Blue Ridge. Kill it, ladies, Glenn Herr says. Nice to know that you are tuning in to WFTDA TV. We are ready to go with action in the third jam.
And here we go. Oh, right away to the front is Buenos Dias picking up lead jammer status. She just made her own way, parting the pack like a curtain.
Well, Buenos Dias, one of the things that Brandywine is very smart about is they have very different styles of jammers, so it makes it difficult for the defense to adjust and adapt.
Yeah, and Sugar Magnolia is in the box. No, excuse me, that's She Rex is in the box. That must be what the official timeout was about. So Buenos Dias picks up 5 points. She's about to go in for her second scoring pass. She Rex is going in for initial pass.
And Decorator is holding her back along with Emma Degenerate. And that's 5 more for Brandywine, Patrick.
Yeah, Buenos Dias, 10 points so far. And there goes the pivot for Blue Ridge. That's a Sugar Magnolia going to the box.
And a quick 5 more racked up by Buenos Dias.
Yeah, She Rex still working on that initial pass. They're not making it easy, definitely. But why would they?
Well, this is one of the things that Brandywine would have learned playing against a team like Victoria's, how to strike back.
Yeah, absolutely. And they have done very well. And look at that. Buenos Dias just pushing that blocker out of her way. 1081. That was, excuse me. 1081.
That was Dixie
yes.
Kicks. Finally through is She Rex, but into the pack already on a fifth scoring run. Excuse me.
Buenos Dias.
It's Buenos Dias, and she calls that one off.
Yeah, big jam for Buenos Dias.
And she gets 3 more. That takes Brandywine to the lead, 24-15.
Well, look how quickly they overcame that jam one kink.
This next jam brought to you by Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality and unmatched performance.
We got Little Mer Madness for Blue Ridge, and we have Not Naughty for Brandywine.
And Little Mer Madness upended. She pulls her way through, gets around Dirty Roxtini, lead jammer.
Not Naughty still dealing with the defense. Little Mer Madness on the first scoring run already. And on the outside, that's... Oh, and she's recycled to the just to the outside. And there goes the jammer for Blue Ridge.
That was Boot Scootin' Bully making that happen for Blue Ridge. Just she had Not Naughty in her sights.
And she finally makes it through. On a scoring run, she calls it off and number 160.
Well, Patrick, you have an admirer. It's Frightmare. Just just signed in at hashtag talk2WFTDA. And Frightmare says, I love you, Plastic Patrick.
I love you, Frightmare.
Well, Brandywine,
yeah,
just as quickly
here.
As they took the lead, Blue Ridge taking it back. It's a one-point game as we get underway.
Yeah, we got Lady Rider for Blue Ridge, and we have a Crash Banshee-Goot for Brandywine, and right away, Lady Rider picks up lead jammer status. They have a two-jammer advantage. Oh, not anymore. Three on three now.
And the notorious R.E.D. penalty box is going to empty out as Skinny Guinea rejoins the action for Brandywine.
Crash Banshee-Goot exits the pack, but Lady Rider is already scoring, and she clears the pack, calls it off after a quick 4 points for Brandywine.
Well,
Hit
and quit will get it done for Blue Ridge tonight, but they want to make a statement. As I said,
yeah.
Gabriel says they play every game like they're playing against Gotham, and they are serious about wanting the Hydra at some point over the next couple of years. That's really awesome to hear a coach say that and be so focused.
Yeah, well, you shoot for the top. G-Rex number 84 for Blue Ridge and Buenos Dias. They had a great jam earlier for the Brandywine Roller Girls.
She racked up a 23-point jam in her last turn at the line. Let's see what she can do this time.
Well, right now they've got her number at the back. She is stuck. And there goes to the front. Buenos Dias, and I'm sorry, G-Rex picks up lead jammer status. Buenos Dias still stuck at the back of the pack. They throw her down and she... Ooh. Is she going to the penalty box?
She is.
Yes.
It's a back block called on Buenos Dias.
That's a power jam for She-Rex. That's her second scoring run.
This is her third jam. So far, scoreless. Now she's got five. Oh, look at that move, ooh. Patrick.
Yeah,
She-Rex. Forward motion, but the pivot, nice play. Quick five.
There she goes in. Oh. And the pack is moving awfully quickly. They cannot hold her back. Of course, the Blue Ridge Roller Girls are staying at the back, but now they've got to contend with the jammer. Buenos Dias coming back to play. She has not performed her initial pass, so no points yet for Brandywine. She-Rex coming in for her second scoring run.
It's Skinny Guinea going to the notorious R.E.D. penalty box now. For Blue Ridge, and that's something we will be keeping track of, is the penalties. It's going to be important down the stretch for Brandywine. They are skating a little bit down, as I said, mm-hmm. with that injury to Anya All Night occurring against Victoria on Thursday night.
Right now, a little less than 20 minutes to go in this period. Blue Ridge 48, Brandywine 24. Blue Ridge sends Little Mer Madness, and Brandywine sends Not Naughty to the jammer line.
And Not Naughty is a powerful jammer, and there she goes, picking up lead. I was going to say she hadn't quite found her stride yet, but she found it on that push through the Blue Ridge pack.
Here it is, and a clear advantage also for the Blue Ridge Roller Girls. They only have two blockers, but...
Well, Not Naughty has to be mindful now. She is going to call that one off.
Yeah, still a blocker left in the notorious R.E.D. penalty box for the Brandywine Roller Girls, but that didn't stop Not Naughty from picking up those 4 points.
Blue Ridge on 48 now. Brandywine at 26. We've got 18 minutes and 45 seconds left to go. So far, it's been one big jam for Brandywine and a lot of solid hitting for Blue Ridge, and that's the difference.
We got Crash Bandicoot facing Lady Rider. And that's Lady Rider picking up lead jammer status. Crash Bandicoot still dealing with the defense, recycled way at the back by 315. That is a coma inducer. And there goes Lady Rider picking up 5 points. A grand slam for her.
Man, Crash Bandicoot just getting the bums rush on the straightaway there, Patrick. Yeah. That's some nice work by that Blue Ridge pack.
Yeah, number 505, Distressa recycling Crash Bandicoot, excuse me.
Well, there's no doubt that there are some Blue Ridge fans watching, and we welcome everyone. We got a couple of tweets now from Brianna Paris. She says, nice recovery madness, and the Regulators Derby say, regulate Blue Ridge, we love you, boom boom.
Yeah, Crash Bandicoot clears the pack, but in the time, Lady Rider calls off the jam after picking up two more points.
56 now for Blue Ridge, 26 for Brandywine, and a little bit Adeline and Gabriel so far have a winning game plan, Patrick. I'm wondering at this point if Coach Hot Wheels might be thinking about a timeout in the next couple of minutes to make sure that Brandywine doesn't let this get out of hand.
Well, 56-26, you know, there's a lot of time left, 50 minutes left almost, so enough time to do. And then enough time for Buenos Diaz to pick up lead jammer status. And a Blue Ridge send out She-Rex. She has not yet cleared the pack, but it's almost done.
Oh, nice engagement by Buenos Diaz. And that is a five-point pass, Patrick.
There she goes. Yeah, they're still holding on to She-Rex. And blockers for Blue Ridge going in and out of the notorious RED penalty box. And there goes one for Brandywine.
And Buenos Diaz, one to beat. She does it. Able to slide her way around coma inducer.
Buenos Diaz hitting the pack again. She-Rex having not having cleared the pack on her initial pass yet.
And she's taken out by Decorator all the way back. Boy, this is a long pack, Patrick, as we're seeing right now.
Number 6, Dirty Boxtini, comes to help Buenos Diaz, and she pushes those two blockers and clears the pack again for a five-point pass. That's 10 so far.
41 for Brandywine, 56 for Blue Ridge, Patrick.
Yeah, you can't count out Brandywine, especially when they send Buenos Diaz to the jammer line. Oh, she's taking a step back. She can try again. There she goes. Pushing on 1081. Dixie kicks.
And an out-of-play call is going to go
and
against
star pass.
Dixie kicks.
It's a star pass to Sugar Magnolia for the Blue Ridge Roller Girls. She clears the pack, puts on the star pivot, but Buenos Diaz calls it off.
Buenos
15 points.
Diaz with 43 points so far in under 15 minutes of roller derby. Really tremendous. And of course, you have to give a lot of credit to the pack on that one too, Patrick. Decorator and Cutthroat Casey were just, they were beasts holding back Blue Ridge.
Yeah. Yeah, sometimes we tend to undermine the work that's done in the pack by the blockers, but you know, you can't play roller derby if you've only got a jammer. Little more madness for Blue Ridge and Not Naughty for Brandywine on the jammer line.
Well, Not Naughty with that rangy style. She definitely has the advantage at this point and picks up lead.
Absolutely. There you go. Pack work for Blue Ridge Roller Girls. And that's
10.
Number 127. Not Naughty picking 160. I think there was a star pass.
10 points separating these two teams now. Not Naughty has a decision to make.
Yeah,
and she makes it. Patrick, you are the guy of guys today. Mischief Managed says, go Blue Ridge, also kisses Plastic Patrick. And Kit Ruff says, Patrick has many fans.
Oh, my God. That means I have to live up to it.
That's right. This next speaking of many fans, this next jam is brought to you by Adam Wheels, a proud partner and official wheel of the WFTDA.
Lady Rider versus Crash Bandicoot. We got 13 minutes left in this period.
And Brandywine at 50, Blue Ridge at 56 on the strength of a couple of really strong jams.
And there goes Lady Rider picking up lead jammer status. Crash Bandicoot right behind her. And it's a jammer race. Is she going to take time? Yeah, it seems like the Blue Ridge, the Brandywine are at the back. There's a chance to pick up points here and to call it right off. That's exactly what she did. Picked up 3 points. Good on Lady Ryder for Blue Ridge.
Nice work by Blue Ridge, taking what Brandywine has and coming back with a positive jam. I've just been handed a note. Sugar Magmalia doesn't often jam, but she had a 45-point jam while playing for Nashville against Little City in 2012. She's actually a former co-record holder of the highest point jam in WFTDA.
Wow, not bad for someone who doesn't jam very much.
That shows you how deep Blue Ridge is.
There goes. Speaking of Blue Ridge, we got She Rex for Blue Ridge and Buenos Dias for Brandywine. And it's actually Buenos Dias that's lead jammer, but She Rex overtakes her, and she is going to hit the pack first. But Buenos Dias knows that, and she calls it right off. A good awareness.
And 50 for Brandywine now. Blue Ridge at 59. Brandywine keeping it close. I guess I underestimated Hot Wheels' bench managing prowess because, a minute ago I said, geez, maybe a timeout would be a good idea. But Brandywine has adjusted on the fly, and you love to see that, Patrick.
Yeah, absolutely. Keep plowing. Keep plowing. Especially this early in the game. Sometimes you just have to get the kinks out, feel off the other team. Mind you, these teams probably know each other by now.
Both playing in the States. The only opponent that they have in common this year, Patrick, was Ithaca, and they were both big winners, although Blue Ridge did a little better. Blue Ridge beat Ithaca by 150, and Brandywine beat Ithaca by 70.
And right now we got Little Mermadness, who picks up lead jammer status and picks up a grand slam, 5 points for Blue Ridge Roller Girls. Not Naughty still working on that initial pass, so they denied access at the front. By 3 very tall.
That's one hit
blockers.
Wounder directing traffic in front, and she is using the new interpretations of the multiplayer block extremely well there, Patrick.
Yeah, absolutely. So well. The Little Mermadness can just scoot around everybody and pick up another grand slam. 10 points so far for Little Mermadness.
69 now to 50 for Blue Ridge.
There she goes. No, she does not clear her. The pack, Not Naughty, having a rough jam.
And a little recycling happening to Mer Madness as well. And that's courtesy of Cutthroat Casey. Oh, and here we have a star pass.
Star pass, yes. Absolutely. Number 6, that is
Dirty Rocks Teeny, and she won't get a chance to score.
Second time she was past the star.
Well, she is a very positive option to have out there. You see a wiry build, and in today's roller derby, that wiry build really helps in so many ways. I mean, she's such a powerful pivot. You almost would rather see her in a pivot position, but it's nice to be able to hand her the star, too.
Oh, absolutely. You have that option. As soon as that helmet's on her head, you've got that option. We got Lady Ryder for Blue Ridge, and we have Cranch Banshegut for Brandywine. And on the outside, one more blocker to beat, number 315. That's Coma Inducer. Two more, and she does pick up lead jammer status.
Oh, and a high block is going to take Dirty Rocks Teeny off the track, Patrick.
Crash Batchy Hoot working on that first scoring run. Lady Ryder is still stuck in the pack.
71 for Blue Ridge right now, 50 for Brandywine.
Lady Ryder clears the pack. Crash Banshegut. She's picked up a few points by now. I say she just called it off.
That's smart exactly to call that
did.
Off.
Yeah, 3 points for Crash Banshegut and the Brandywine Roller Girls. 71 for Blue Ridge, 53 for Brandywine. 9 minutes, 15 seconds left in the period.
So far, we have not seen many jams where both jammers are getting through. That is a testament to the pack play.
Yeah.
And it seems like whichever jammer finds that quick hole early is going to get out front.
You got Sugar Magmolia for Blue Ridge and Buenos Dias for Brandywine. And quickly, it's Sugar Magmolia blowing kisses, picking up lead jammer status. Buenos Dias. Very good bout so far, but she seems to be hit or miss, as this one is really giving her trouble.
Oh, and nice work there. Just a decorator thought had her on that one, Patrick.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Sugar Magnolia picking up a grand slam right there. Nice pack work. Buenas Dias stuck behind double zero. Brutal. And now three blockers for Blue Ridge All-Star. Nice recycling at the French. 160 also.
Decorator picked up Sugar Magnolia that time. She wasn't going to let her go twice. No doubt about that.
No.
Oh, and that's a beautiful shot there by Skinny Guinea, forcing the call by Sugar Magnolia.
Yeah, Buenos Dias was coming up to the pack. So Sugar Magnolia calls it off and picks up three extra points. 79 for Blue Ridge, 53 for Brandywine, 7:55 left in the period. They got a game.
Well, I tell you what, the talk to WFTDA is lighting up, Patrick, and we'll get to some of your tweets here in just a second. We don't want to miss any of this action. Brandywine on 53, Blue Ridge on 79, 7 minutes, 35 seconds left.
Yeah, we got She-Rex versus Crass Banchigut, and fast through the pack is She-Rex picking up Lee Jammer. No, she picks up a forearm call.
Oh,
and gets to the notorious RD penalty box. That's a power jam. One of the few power jams we've seen so far.
Absolutely. And immediately calling it off is Crash Banchicoot.
Really? Calls it off so quickly. I guess they want to put in a new pair of fresh legs.
Well, they're putting in Skinny Guinea. Skinny Guinea has not been jamming a whole lot so far. This could be... Skinny Guinea is a very capable jammer. Very, very agile, especially from side to side. And maybe Hot Wheels thinks that this is the time to shake things up a little bit in the Brandywine order. This could be a big move.
Well, maybe she likes to come in for drama. And a power jam is definitely drama. Mind you, not so much now that they only last 30 seconds.
Well, that's true. And, boy, Coma Inducer is making life difficult for Skinny Guinea right now, along with Sugar Magmalia. They're going to take her all the way back, and that's going to kill some clock,
Yeah,
Patrick.
That's the point right here, is to kill some time so that She-Rex can come back to play. Speaking of which, she's coming back. Lee Jammer status still available, as Skinny Guinea has not picked up Lee Jammer status yet. So this... could have been a great opportunity.
Finally, Skinny Guinea makes it through.
Yeah. She picks it up. She-Rex is all tangled up. Oof.
Boy, She-Rex has a lot of power. You saw Decorator give her all she had, and T-Rex just bounced it off, shrugged it off. But look at Skinny Guinea go.
Yeah, Skinny Guinea going after that jammer for the fourth point, for the fifth point. No, she picks up four. Calls it off. Good power jam kill for the Blue Ridge Roller Girls.
Yep, that's four for Brandywine, but that kind of has to go down as a moral victory for Blue Ridge. Blue Ridge
absolutely.
On 79, Brandywine on 57. And Patrick, we hear from Kathy Lynn Furtkus. She says, that's right, even the Oklahoma Victory Dolls super fans love Plastic Patrick. Thanks for coming to ECDX. And Katie Court says, so excited to hear our two favorite announcers
Woo-hoo!
Working together on the Brandywine game. Thank you for all of that, and keep calling us up at Talk to WFTDA.
Crash Banchigut picking up lead jammer status. Lady Rider is jamming for Blue Ridge, and she clears the pack as well. Not lead jammer, as you see that beautiful eagle-like motion by the referee.
And it's 3-on-3 in the pack. Crash Banchicoot's going to try and get what she can.
Lady Rider coming right up to the pack. Oh, she calls it right off. Does she pick up any? She picks up three.
Well, Brandywine will take three at this point in the bout. They are certainly keeping up. They have 59 right now. Blue Ridge with 79. This next bout is brought to you by Bont Green Monster and S1 Helmets. Thank you to our WFTDA partners.
We got Little More Madness for Blue Ridge Roller Girls and Buenas Dias for Brandywine. And there she goes on the outside. Little More Madness, door was shut for her. At the front, Buenos Dias. There she is. This looks like a good jam for Buenos Dias. She was recycled at the back. She falls. She has to go way. Oh, and what a hit.
That was not naughty. And not only does she make the jammer kill, but she forces the cut.
Yeah.
And it's another power jam for Brandywine.
Yeah, Buenos Dias is the one you want out there when you get a power jam. She picks up lead jammer status. That was a tough initial pass, though. Here she goes, hitting the pack again. Let's see if her blockers can clear it out for her somehow. So one more to beat. And she's pushing, pushing, pushing. That's the captain, number zero, Brutal.
And that's five more for Brandywine. They're on 64 now.
Yeah, Dixie Kicks, that was for Blue Ridge. And here she comes again. Of course, Blue Ridge racing the pack. They can't race it too far, though.
Well, we have a whistle.
Buenos Dias throws this up into the pack. Little Mermadness still.
She's back on the track now, Patrick, yep. And she's got a vendetta. Look at her get through on that initial pass.
Well, she got a 30-second break that she did not want, so she wants to make up for it.
What?
Buenos Dias picks up 3 points.
Is that three more for Buenos Dias? Buenos Dias currently with 51 points in this first period, and that is she is the jammer of the bout so far. High-scoring jammer for Blue Ridge is Lady Rider, no slouch, with 30 points herself. We got 2 minutes, 28 seconds left, and these teams are 12 points apart.
You got Lady Rider for Blue Ridge and Crash Bandicoot for Brandywine, and right now, there goes Lady Rider going back. You know, you can do that now. It seems like a new thing
for
the derby. Backwards derby. I'm kind of enjoying it.
That kind of shows you that Blue Ridge is respecting what Brandywine is doing right now, and they just want to go into the halftime with the lead.
Yeah, absolutely. Here comes Lady Rider.
She's going to call.
Whoa, she was not lead jammer. She was not lead jammer. She thought she was. No initial pass has been performed yet. I guess that could be confusing.
And it's a jammer race.
Both jammers clear the pack, and that was a 0-0. It seems like that's a new thing, the backwards derby. She got recycled way, way, way at the back, and she was hoping that the pack would eat the baby, but did not happen.
No,
Crash Bandicoot came right back in, right behind her, just in front of the pack.
And 1 minute, 15 seconds. Brandywine with 67, Blue Ridge with 79, and this bout is everything that it was cracked up to be. If you looked at the rankings coming in, Brandywine the 49 and Blue Ridge the 41.
There we go again. That's She-Rex pushing at the front for Blue Ridge, and Not Naughty recycled at the back for Brandywine. Going on the outside here, she goes, no, not yet. Oh. She's pushed to the inside, she hits the ground.
Boy, she popped right back up, though. Not Naughty. And, there you go. What conditioning, Patrick.
Yes.
She picks up lead jammer. This lady has played 3 bouts in the last 4 days, and you would never know it watching her on that last jam.
No, absolutely. Decker Hader going to the penalty box, and the notorious RED penalty box, but what work has she done for that pack? Not Naughty calling it off. After picking up 3 points.
And that takes Brandywine up to 70. It's a 9-point game. The period clock running down. We'll see whether we get another one in. Kilty Winterstein says the Brandywine Blue Ridge game is really great. Preview of the D2 championship game? Question mark?
Ooh, let's see.
Thank you for that. You never know, Kilty. You may be right. And this could be halftime. We're going to make sure of this before yes, Patrick, that is what we have. And what a half this has been.
Yeah,
Brandywine, early on it looked like Blue Ridge might be on a run. Brandywine, without calling the timeout, just powering through a little downstretch. And ever since about 10 minutes into this bout, they've been getting the upper hand.
Absolutely. If we look at the penalty situation, Brandywine seems to be a little bit more penalty heavy. They have 1, 2, 3 skaters, Rapid Arrhythmia, Dirty Roxtini, and Skinny Guinea with 4 penalties each. Nobody above 3-3 Sugar Mamolia for Blue Ridge, and that's the most. It's going to be a factor in the second half. 4 penalties in the first half seems to be a lot, because 7, you get ejected.
Sure.
And Brandywine is working with 13 skaters right now, so they can't really afford to lose a lot of skaters. It might be rough on them. They are trailing a little bit by 9 points, and you've got to clean up those penalties.
Well, that's certainly the case, Patrick. On the other hand, Brandywine in the position as the lower ranked team here, they can't let up. They have to keep pushing. And, hey, sometimes, you know, that's the measure of a skater, yeah, is how well they can perform with those four or maybe even five penalties and continue to be effective. And, you know, obviously Dirty Rocks Teeny is going to have to be on the track for Brandywine to have, yeah, a chance in this one, as is Skinny Guinea.
Yeah, looks like we're going to give it to you. Take a break now, and we will be back for the second half of Blue Ridge Brandywine. 79 for Blue Ridge, 70 for Brandywine in about 12 minutes. We are live at ECDX, a Blue Ridge versus Brandywine on track two. Blue Ridge sitting at 79, Brandywine trailing at 70. And Gretchen, let's discuss the season that these two teams are having so far.
Well, and I want to give a shout out to Frightmare, who reached out on hashtag Talk2WFTDA, pointing out that both of these teams have also played the DC Roller Girls and this year, which is absolutely correct. Oh. And Brandywine lost to DC on June 8th by 93 points. DC won that one 207 to 114. At Blue Ridge, on the other hand, lost DC early in the year on February 9th by only 9 points. DC pulling that one out 161 to 152. Other than that, Brandywine at 5-5. They've got a win against Cincinnati, a win against Ithaca, a win against Tri-City, the loss against Nashville at Southern Discomfort, a win against Charlotte, a win against Green Mountain, a loss against Toronto, that loss against DC, a loss against Helsinki on Wednesday, and a loss against Victoria on Thursday. And now they are 9 points down to Blue Ridge.
Yeah, speaking of Blue Ridge, they have had a very interesting season. Started off with two losses, one against DC, one against Gold Coast, and then they went on a winning streak. First against Lowcountry, then against Neo, then Fort Myers, Fargo-Moorhead, Carolina, Royal Windsor, Dallas, Ithaca, and Duke City, which brings us to right now against Brandywine. So two losses to start off the year and an 8-win streak, which could potentially be broken today.
And that streak has a lot to do with their number 41 ranking. You can see that, yeah, they have been climbing up the rankings since December of last year. They were at 53. They were at 51 as of February. As of March, they were at 45. As of April, they were at 43. And they are currently at 41, knocking on D1's, yeah, door, Patrick.
Absolutely. But they've only played teams that were ranked lower. And in order to climb quicker, shall we say, you have to play teams that are ranked higher, therefore you score more points for the WFTDA rankings.
With the exception of DC, as Frightmare pointed out.
Absolutely.
You know, it looks like we're
ready to
go. This first jam brought to you by Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, RydellSkates.com.
We got Sugar Magnolia for Blue Ridge and Not Naughty for Brandywine to start off the second half. And right away, quickly, that's Sugar Magnolia picking up lead jammer status. 273 Not Naughty is still tangled up. She gets rid of that and also performs her initial pass, but here comes Sugar Magnolia on a scoring run. Both blockers for Brandywine jetting to the front. She makes quick work of that, picks up four and calls it off.
And that'll take Blue Ridge to 83. Not Naughty doing a good job holding Blue Ridge, yeah, to four on that one. Sugar Magnolia got out of the pack so fast, yeah, on that last one, Patrick.
Absolutely, and she only had, there were only two blockers to keep her from getting out, so good on her for taking advantage of that blocker advantage. She-Rex versus Crash Bandicoot. Oh. And quickly, she wrecks. There we go. Two lead jammer calls in a row for Blue Ridge. I think they had a good meeting in the halftime.
Yeah, I think that Gabriel saw an opening on the outside of that initial pack formation, and they've exploited it in those last two jam starts.
Yeah, absolutely. 4 points for She-Rex. And here we go with a track cut on Crash Banshee-Coot. She's going to sit in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for 30 seconds and let She-Rex do what she does best and score points. Oh, skating backwards, trying to get that final blocker out of her way. She gets it. 5 points. That's 10 so far for She-Rex.
Well, Rapid Arrhythmia are going to be called off on a low block.
And right now, only two blockers for Blue Ridge, for Brandywine, excuse me, to keep She-Rex from damaging the score for Brandywine. Brings them to 92-70 for Brandywine and counting.
Well, rejoining the action was
Crash Banshee-Coot.
Go ahead, Patrick.
Crash Banshee-Coot rejoins the action, but that was her initial pass. And, oh, is she called out again? I don't think so.
Three more on the board for Blue Ridge, and they are at 100. Yeah. Brandywine at 70, and so far, this is a Blue Ridge beginning to this second period.
Absolutely. And Brandywine is going to send out the go-to jammer so far, Buenos Dias, 51 points in the bout. Let's see what she can do. Little More Madness is the one for Blue Ridge. And here she is, Buenos Dias, pushing at the front against a big wall of four blockers. That's a tall order.
Dirty Roxtini got away with one there. She threw off her pivot cover right as the jam began because she noticed that the pivot for Brandywine was sitting in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Wilmer Madness has picked up lead jammer status. She is, she went in, quickly clears the pack and calls off the jam. That was a really, really lucky pass on the inside.
You see her getting some love from her coach Gabriel there, and that is what Blue Ridge needs to do to start this one off, establish the dominance of the pack. And so far they've done it. They've been springing their jammers, and it's been on the outside of the straightaway. Brandywine's going to have to close that gap.
And here we go again with the Skinny Guinea. Skinny Guinea for Brandywine and Lady Rider for Blue Ridge. Nobody's in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box, so full contingent of blockers for both teams. Lady Rider, here we go again. Third lead jammer call in a row.
Oh, and Skinny Guinea is able to push her way past.
She clears the pack, but here comes Lady Rider in a scoring run. Oh, she turns around to get those hips in front of those hips, and she picks up 2 points, I believe.
Now, Skinny Guinea was
picked up. No, sorry. Zero.
Skinny Guinea was closing fast. Blue Ridge on 104. Brandywine still on 70. We got the Carolina Roller Girls saying, go Blue Ridge. Watching ECDX and listening to the always lovely commentary of Plastic Patrick. There they go again.
She-Rex for Blue Ridge Roller Girls. Brandywine for Crash Banshee-Coot for Brandywine. Crash Banshee-Coot at the back, stuck behind a big wall of three. She-Rex recycled at the back. Oh, here she goes, number six. Excellent, Dirty Roxtini.
Nice work by Dirty Roxtini. She heard a whistle early on and thought, oh my God, am I getting called off again?
Well, she's sitting on four penalties.
She's got to be careful.
Yeah, she's got to watch it. But Crash Banshee-Coot picks up lead jammer status. She-Rex also cleared the pack. Here comes Crash.
Three on three pack right now. Crash is going to pick up the ghost point, or is she? Yes, she does.
Yep, 2 points. When you pass one blocker, you pick up the point for the blocker that's in the box. And that's what she did, 2 points. Well, first points for Brandywine in this half.
That's an important jam. They couldn't let that drought go on any longer, Patrick. And, one each in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box as we start this next jam.
We got a Little More Madness for Blue Ridge and Buenos Dias for Brandywine.
Buenos Dias, the high scorer so far, 51 points.
Little More Madness can... Oh, I love it when blockers turn around and block with their chest. And here goes Buenos Dias at the front, containing with the blocker. She's pushed to the outside, and right away, Little Mer Madness picks up lead jammer status. Buenos Dias still contending with the defense. She's got one more to go. And she's pushed to the inside. She has to recycle at the back. And so does Little Mer Madness, but she's on a scoring run. Number nine, Skinny Guinea, recycles way. And there we go with the backwards derby again. You do have to stay in the engagement zone, though. That's an awfully long engagement zone.
Well, nice work of bridging by Dirty Rocks Teeny and Decorator.
And Buenos Dias still contending with the blockers at the front. Here we go again with number six, a Dirty Rocks Teeny, recycling Little Mer Madness on that scoring run. But she's got time because Buenos Dias is still working on that initial pass.
Yeah, things are basically going Blue Ridge's way so far in this second period, Patrick. Oh, and we have a track cut.
Buenos Dias gets sent to the Torreciardi penalty box. And there we go, that two-fist pumping of the coach. That's Coach Gabriel signaling, Little Mer Madness, you got a power jam. C'est un super jam.
33 seconds, 30s now, still on this jam clock, so plenty of time for Little Mer Madness to pick up a few more. That is the second penalty for Buenos Dias. She is not in the penalty trouble that many of the other Brandywine skaters are, Patrick.
Oh, what a great penalty kill that Brandywine is performing right now. She has had one, this is the first scoring run of her jam, and it was on a power jam. Here comes Buenos Dias. She has to perform her initial pass, and why would she stop it?
Buenos Dias pulling through. Does she get anything at the end? No, she does not.
No, and that was the initial pass.
McTavish is talking to us on at #talk2WFTDA. He says, who are we? BRG.
That's got to be Brandywine Roller Girls.
Back to the action now, Patrick. And, oh, it's another lead jam picked up. Sugar Magmalia.
Yeah, absolutely. Not naughty on there for the Brandywine Roller Girls. She clears the pack as well, but Sugar Magmalia is scoring. She's stuck behind two blockers. She takes care of that and calls it off furiously. Picks up all four. Does she pick up all four?
Yes, she did, Patrick, and nothing on the board for Brandywine.
Yes.
Blue Ridge now at 113, Brandywine at 72, and Brandywine looking for some lightning in a bottle right now.
Yeah.
They need it.
Yeah, they've got to make a move. 21 minutes left. They're trailing by some 40-something points. They've got to make it happen now. Here we go with She-Rex and Crash Bandicoot for the respective teams. Pushing at the front to She-Rex. Crash Bandicoot held behind two very strong blockers. Oh, sent flying into the crowd is She-Rex. Recycled by two very powerful Brandywine blockers. 757 Cutthroat KC was one of them.
Well, that shot by Decorator earned her a forearm trip to the Notarius R.E.D. penalty box. That's her fifth box trip now, Patrick, as the penalty woes continue for Brandywine.
And Crash Bandicoot recycled also, but did the blocker fell out, so she's able to go ahead. She-Rex is chasing her. She picked up one scoring pass, I believe, 4 points. And she called off the jam. There we go. Blue Ridge really increasing their lead. 117 to 72 for Brandywine. 20 minutes left in the period. Just want to mention that over on track three, Tiger Bailey's Providence, 99 to 52. And there are 8 minutes left in the first half.
Well, we have some tweets from the hashtag #talk2WFTDA. Amy Lloyd says, Tiger Bay are blowing my mind. Speaking of that, Patrick.
Well, roller derby blows my mind all the time.
We have a timeout now called by Gabriel. Israel. And no, excuse me, that's called by Coach Hot Wheels for Brandywine. They need to talk things over right now. Yeah. A notorious second half team are Brandywine. And for that Ithaca bout, for example, they were actually down at halftime before coming roaring back. Yeah. So they have it in them. They've got spurts. We saw it in this first period. However, as we said before, penalties now a problem. Decorator has five. Rapid Arrhythmia has now picked up five. And Dirty Rockstini sitting with four penalties. Absolutely. This,
those are all very important players.
This could be attrition working against Brandywine right now.
Absolutely. Litterman Madness taking the jammer line for Blue Ridge. Blue Ridge in the black and in the white. Brandywine send out Buenos Dias. Again, the go-to jammer for the team. Buenos Dias so far sitting at 51 points, but all done in the first half.
Brandywine with one blocker standing. She resumes the play.
Loomer Madness recycle at the back. Buenos Dias pushing at the front behind a big wall of three. A very dynamic wall, not straight across, but very dynamic in a triangular formation.
That's solid work by Cutthroat Casey.
Loomer Madness recycled at the back.
Rapid Arrhythmia pulling that. Oh, but we have a jammer penalty on Buenos Dias.
Buenos Dias, a little more madness is going to be on a power jam. C'est un super jam pour Blue Ridge Roller Girls, but she has to contend with the defense. She does have to perform her initial pass. And, of course, as soon as I say that, she performs it.
Well, this penalty-killing situation is going to stretch Brandywine. Yeah. They are really going to have to suck it up now in order to be able to contain Blue Ridge.
Yeah, a little more madness. There we go. Pushing at the front. Oh, and four. Big wall of four blockers at the front. Not moving very much. That's got to be tough on Little More Madness. If she makes it through, those will be five very hard-earned points.
Well, a multiplayer block is going to be called on Dirty Rockstini. And Buenos Dias is back from the notorious RED penalty box. She had been sent there on a low block. It is her third penalty. She is now attempting to make an initial pass.
Yeah, absolutely. And just as we say that, Little More Madness is trying to complete her second scoring run. Speaking of Dirty Rockstini, she too is sitting at five penalties. So one, two, three, four blockers for Brandywine sitting on five penalties.
And 122 Blue Ridge will go up by five now.
Yep, Little More Madness clears the pack and picks up 5 points, 10 in this jam. Blue Ridge 127, Brandywine 72. There we go. High five from Coach Gabriel. Well deserved.
Well, he said he wants the Hydra. He might not get it this year. He loves Division II, but he's salivating, and it looks like his team is salivating as well for a shot at Division I.
Absolutely.
Taking control of this second half now is Blue Ridge.
Lady Rider number 5. For Blue Ridge and Skinny Guinea, number 9 for Brandywine. And there goes Lady Rider picking up lead jammer status. What a domination this team is having on period 2. They have had every lead jammer call so far. Boat jammers exit the pack. Lady Rider's in the front. She has control of the clock. That clears the pack so easily. The pack was moving at light speed, and I guess that really works with her style. She picks up four and calls off the jam.
The pack is fast, but Lady Rider is faster. If you want to be faster in this wonderful sport of roller derby, you need Adam Wheels. They are a proud partner and the official wheel of the WFTDA. Look them up online, adamwheels.com.
And we got She-Rex for Blue Ridge and Crash Banshee-Coot for Brandywine.
And She-Rex picking up lead and losing position for just a second, but it's a big pack advantage for Blue Ridge.
Yeah, absolutely. She picks up, continues the stronghold that they've had on lead jammer status in this period so far. Still stuck in the pack, Crash Banshee-Coot. She clears the pack, of course, as soon as I talk about it. But She Rex is already scoring. She's recycled at the back.
Well, and just as the notorious RED penalty box unloads a couple of Brandywine players, two more go in. Decorator now has six penalties. Whew. Can she stay in the game?
Well, she's got the question. Minutes to go.
Yep. Blue Ridge doing it one jam at a time. 133 now to Brandywine's 72.
And we will have Little More Madness for Blue Ridge. Little More Madness, 41 points in the bout so far. Very hot scorer. She Rex has 42. Lady Rider has 34. So evenly split for Blue Ridge. And on Brandywine's side, we got Buenos Dias
with the big 51. Yeah, as a coach, I'm sure that Gabriel is very happy to see such balance of scoring from the Blue Ridge All-Stars.
Yeah, deep bench. Very deep bench, and it's paying off for them because they're all picking up lead jammer status one after the other. Buenos Dias still has one more blocker to go. That's brutal. She clears the pack, but Little More Madness is creeping up at the back of that pack to score points. She clears that pack like nobody's business and picks up 4 points. Very quick work.
Well, Blue Ridge just continuing to add to the lead. The second half scoring, 49 for Blue Ridge and only two for Brandywine. You know, you got to give Brandywine a lot of props, though. As hard as Blue Ridge has been coming at this second half, it could be more. They've been picking up lead every time. Yeah. And somehow Brandywine is just digging deep to prevent them from coming up with a big jam.
Yeah, we got Not Naughty for Brandywine. Oh, Not Naughty picks up lead jammer status for her team. Is this the turnaround that they've been looking for? Lady Rider clears the pack as well, so it's not going to be a very long jam, I predict. Not Naughty hitting the pack. All the blockers for Blue Ridge are at the front. And she picks up one.
1 point for Not Naughty, but that's better than losing four.
Yeah, and, absolutely.
You see her going over to the bench there. And, you know, hey, they've played a lot of derby in the last 4 days. And as Coach Hot Wheels said, they're learning every time they play. When you're talking about a number 49 team playing against a number 41 team, this point differential is really not something that's out of the out of the imagination.
No. She Rex number 84 for Blue Ridge and Crash Bandicoot for Brandywine. Two lead jam calls in a row. Crash Bandicoot steps up and picks up lead jammer, but not a lot of space between her and She Rex, and She Rex is coming at her fast, and Pack is moving very quickly. Well, she's going to pick up one at least and calls it right off furiously. Her pack, very good pack awareness as they pushed one blocker out to make sure that she would pass her.
Well, Brandywine sitting on two lead jams in a row. That's got to give them some measure of confidence coming into the final 12 minutes. Mm. They have 75 now. A realistic goal for them at this point is to hit that 100 mark.
Yeah.
Keep Blue Ridge under 150. And they could walk away saying, we've done a respectable job.
Even bout-ish. Little More Madness for Blue Ridge and Buenos Dias for Brandywine. On the outside, we got Little More Madness dealing with two blockers. Of course, Dirty Roxtini is one of them.
Well, Dirty Roxtini now on six penalties, as is Cutthroat KC. The penalty woes continue to mount. The Brandywine now has three players with six penalties.
And Little More Madness hits the pack. Buenos Dias has cleared her initial pass, but quickly clearing the pack is Little More Madness. Did she call it off? She does. So she picks up four and calls it right off. So creeping up, 141 to 75, favoring Blue Ridge. 11 minutes and a half left in the period, Miss Gretchen.
Well, can Brandywine keep their players on the track now? That certainly will be a question mark. Rapid arrhythmia with five penalties. Dirty Roxtini, as we said, with six. Decker Hader with six. Skinny Guinea with six. The only thing close to penalty trouble for Blue Ridge, Sugar Magnolia with five.
And there goes Not Naughty for Brandywine and Lady Rider for Blue Ridge. And she is going to the box. Not Naughty.
Called for a back block. That hurts.
Yeah, because Lady Rider just picked up lead jammer status, and she is going to go back in and score on that power jam. And of course, one blocker down for Brandywine. Not so bad, but they're not going to make it easy on her.
Well, Skinny Guinea fighting hard and draws a penalty.
Yeah, blocking with the head.
That will spring Not Naughty from the notorious RED penalty box. Let's see what she can do. This jam will go a full 2 minutes, Patrick.
That's right, no lead jammer. And here comes Not Naughty. She clears the pack. That was the initial pass. And I love that eagle-like motion that says you're not lead jammer.
Oh, and Not Naughty hits that pack hard.
Yeah. And she gets through. She good awareness on her, thinking that the blocker that had hit her out fell down. So she was able to come right back in. Lady Rider hits the pack again. Her penalty's over. Brad quickly through is Not Naughty. Nobody's going to call this one off. There's no lead jammer. Lady Rider clears the pack as well. Picks up four. Here comes Not Naughty once again.
Great conditioning by these Brandywine skaters. Not Naughty looking like she's been taking a week's vacation instead of playing three bouts as she hits that pack again and again.
And here goes Lady Rider picking up four also. Not Naughty is going to hit the pack. There's 10 seconds left. She really wants those points. She's recycled at the back by number 84, excuse me, she wrecks.
And boy, Blue Ridge making hay while the sun shines as well. But you got to give it up for Not Naughty on that last jam. Completely changing Brandywine's scoring pattern in this second period. And now they're at 88. And they have a legitimate chance with eight minutes left to get over 100 and get significantly over 100.
Yeah. And I apologize. That last hit was brought to you by Boot School and Bully. Not She-Rex, because She-Rex is on the jammer line now for Blue Ridge, as well as Crash Banshee-Coot for Brandywine.
And
there we go.
Track cut will send She-Rex out.
Well, if there's, if they want to stand a chance, they've got to draw those penalties, and they seem like they're doing it now. Oh, she's picked up lead jammer status. She looked like she went out of bounds, but no luck. Crash Banshee-Coot picks up lead jammer. And she's on a power jam.
Boy, she doesn't have much pack help, though.
Nope.
Two skaters in the notorious RED penalty box for Brandywine, but she's already picked up a couple, Patrick.
Yeah, and that was Dixie Kicks pushing her to the outside. She's going to recycle. She's already making her way to the front.
And Starbucks doing a good job of offensive blocking there. Rapid Arrhythmia has just fouled out of the game, Patrick. She has picked up her seventh.
And that is why Brandywine is a little low in the blocker department right now. Even though Crash Banshee-Coot is on a power jam. Oh, power jam no more. She-Rex came back into play. Did not pick up any points, but Brandywine now sitting at 93 in Blue Ridge, 154, 7:15 left in the period.
And Crash Banshee-Coot, she has 15 points now, but those 10 or so points that she picked up before in that last jam, very important for Brandywine.
Yeah. Yeah, at this point, if they're not going to win, they've got to close the gap.
Yes, Rapid Arrhythmia out. Decorator at six penalties. Skinny Guinea with six. Dirty Roxtini with six. But they have to keep playing now, Patrick.
That's right. Little More Madness for Blue Ridge and Buenos Dias for Brandywine. And Buenos Dias is going out on a... I did not see that call.
It's a back block.
Yeah.
Yes, Patrick.
Buenos Dias on a back block, which puts Little More Madness in a power jam.
I tell you, these Brandywine belligerents are determined, though. They are not making it easy.
Well, no, but This is not what they wanted to happen right now. But at least they're working with four blockers now. Four on four. Actually, nobody's sitting in the Buenos in a notorious RED penalty box other than Buenos Diaz.
Buenos Diaz with four penalties now. Not necessarily a problem with 6 minutes to go.
And there goes Little More Madness with five. And the room suddenly got very quiet.
Starbucks is going to have to sit down as well for Brandywine. That'll be her fourth trip to the box. Back on the track.
Here comes Buenos Diaz hitting the pack. Little More Madness is hitting the pack as well. Buenos Diaz is on the initial pass, so there's no reason for Little More Madness to call it off.
Oh, and Sugar Mag Malia going hard at her and drawing the penalty. A high block, Patrick, is going to sit Buenos Diaz back down.
Still on a power jam, Little More Madness. A second power jam in the same jam. You do not want that happening because, well, Little More Madness is only on her second scoring run, actually. So good penalty kill on the Brandywine blocking contingent.
Yep, it's stretching them to the limit, though, to have to do it twice in one jam. Yeah. You see Little More Madness with a little bit of inside-out move. That was an easy 5 points as the jam times out.
Yeah, and just as the jam ended, Buenos Diaz came back into play, but no time.
Well, I'd like to check the...
Blue Ridge sitting on 169, Brandywine 93, 4 minutes 40 left in the bout.
Make sure to talk to us at hashtag talk2WFTDA. We want to thank all the fans for being part of this game with us today, Patrick.
Absolutely. Lady Rider for Blue Ridge. And I do not know who that is for Brandywine. It's not Naughty. She's stuck in the pack. Lady Rider has cleared her initial pass. She's coming back in fast. Everyone's trying to have a go at her, but the wall for Brandywine seems a little disorganized, and she gets through right away. Last line of defense was number 69, Emma DeGenerat.
And Dirty Roxtini showing the... showing the fact that she has six penalties there, just couldn't take that big hit that you saw in her eyes wanted to take.
Oh, yeah.
Brandywine on 93, the period clock winding down, 3:37. Next on track two, we've got Connecticut versus Garden State. That's going to be a backyard battle. It's going to be an awesome bout, and we're looking forward to that one, too. So keep tuned to WFTDA-TV.
Sugar Magmolia going to the jammer line for Blue Ridge. And we got Crash Banshee-Coot for Brandywine. And here we go at the front. It's Crash Banshee-Coot picking up lead jammer status. A well-needed, much-needed lead jammer status. Little Sugar Magmolia pushed at the on the outside. And in the meantime, Crash Banshee-Coot skated. Nobody noticed. She picked up 5 points.
How about these Brandywine belligerents, you know? Like I said, there is 10 quick ones for Crash Banshee-Coot.
Yeah, so 10 points so far. Sugar Magmolia has exited the pack, and Crash Banshee-Coot knows it, so she calls it right off.
Brandywine up over that crucial 100 mark. They hit 103 with that last jam. Crash Banshee-Coot now has 25 points on the bout. She's been skating cleanly, only one penalty for her. Sugar Magmolia, the only skater in penalty trouble for Blue Ridge with six penalties. And we have a timeout now being called by Blue Ridge.
By Brandywine,
yes. Pardon me.
Yes, when you see those diamonds shining at the bottom of the screen, yes, they are diamonds. That means the team is taking a timeout. don't we love shining diamonds? Why don't you talk to us about that on Talk to WFTDA? Shiny diamonds.
Rihanna is watching, I understand. And she's shining bright like a diamond as we speak. WFTDA.TV sponsors allow you, if you're a business person, either in the derby business or a peripheral business, or just just wanting to reach an amazing international market, think about sponsoring WFTDA.TV. Talk directly to thousands of Derby fans by advertising on WFTDA-TV. Contact sponsorship at WFTDA.com.
And maybe one of us can read out your ads. Lady Rider takes the line for Blue Ridge Roller Girls and Buenos Dias Brandywine. And here we go. And what? No, probably the second to last jam. 2 minutes, 2.5 minutes left in the bout. Buenos Dias is pushing at the front.
Well, and Dirty Roxtini didn't let the fact that she has six penalties work against her on that last bump out.
Buenos Dias is the lead jammer. She's coming in laying low, hoping nobody will see her, but too late. She's hit that pack. The front wall cannot contain her. Buenos Dias is having one of those jams like she did at the top of the bout. She has picked up 5 points, a grand slam. Lady Rider picked up. She cleared the pack, and Buenos Dias knew it, so she called it right off. We're going to start with a fresh jammer.
Brandywine on 108 now. Blue Ridge still at 174. 149 left, and another timeout called by Blue Ridge this time, Patrick.
That's right. They want to take a timeout and regroup. They, you know, they're pretty much in control at this point. They're pretty much in control. They want to increase their point, the point differential, because they are at 41, 108 for Brandywine, 41 ranked, 49 ranked. You've got to beat them by a sizable lead in order to, you know, really get a decent bump.
Right. And Brandywine, of course, with the, you know, the Helsinki game was a shocker. Yeah. But when you watch Helsinki and see what they did against Charlottesville, Helsinki only lost to Charlottesville by a score of 187 to 168 here on track two in the first bout of the day. You know, that may have been an outlier, or just the fact that Helsinki had not played many American teams. But really, Brandywine did not acquit themselves poorly against Victoria at all. So they've got to be proud of themselves at this point in this bout.
Or maybe it just means that Helsinki and Charlottesville are both grossly underranked.
Well, that's something that will remain to be seen, because, of course, the June 30th rankings will be coming right on the heels of this very important ECDX 2014.
Yeah, absolutely. Litterman Madness taking the line for Blue Ridge, and Not Naughty for Brandywine. And at the front, we got Litterman Madness. Pushing and pushing. She's recycled at the back.
And that's Dirty Roxtini doing the work again for Brandywine, Patrick.
Yeah, she does not let up. She does not let six penalties get in her way.
And Decker Ader has now fouled out for Brandywine as well. So there is their list of available blockers is getting thinner by the moment.
And while that's happening, Littlemer Madness has hit the pack on a scoring run. And she's going to milk the clock, because Not Naughty has cleared the pack as well. She's about to hit the pack, but you know Littlemer Madness is just thinking, ladies, race the pack so we can eat up some time.
Well, maybe she's thinking about just letting this one roll out now. Big hit.
Yeah, a big hit on the inside. Pushes Not Naughty to the ground. But both jammers, and here we go with the backwards derby again.
Boy, Cutthroat Casey recycling Little Mer Madness all the way back.
Yeah, all the way back and more. Much further back. And here we go at the front. Little Mer Madness clears the pack on her second scoring run. 10 points so far. That timeout really did pay off. Not Naughty still working on that initial pass. She is having no luck. And she gets called out for a track cut.
Oh, that will seal the deal.
Yeah.
For Brandywine on 108 as the period clock is running down. Game is in Blue Ridge's hands now, Patrick.
Yeah, absolutely. Wilmer Madness, you know, is going to go all the way. There will be 6 seconds left after this jam is timed out. Will somebody be quick enough to call a timeout?
Well, the period clock has expired, and so that's going to do it. And I believe that's going to be your score, 193 for Blue Ridge, 108 for Brandywine, as Not Naughty has to sit down to watch the final jam of the bout with the star on her head. And penalties, of course, as we said all along, the story. Brandywine skating low to begin with a 13-player roster. We're going to be going to Megatron in a minute with the post-game interview. But honestly, Patrick, Brandywine came to play this bout, and Blue Ridge came to play as well, no doubt about it. No big surprises in the outcome.
No, I mean, there were, you know, like we said earlier, ranked 41st and 49. Relatively, you know, decent score for these two. So I don't think neither team is going to benefit a whole lot from that point differential. However, in experience, you know, no team can say that about leaves no experience. Of course, Brandywine is going to go home and think, you know, we got to clean up those penalties. They had three foul outs, Skinny Guinea, Cutthroat Case, Decorator, and Rapid Arrhythmia fouled out on a roster of 13. That's not very profitable.
No.
Blue Ridge's side, you know, six trips for Sugar Magnolia, but everyone else has 3, 2, 1, or 0. So, you know, good on Blue Ridge for skating clean, and Brandywine is going to go home and think about this.
Brandywine pushing it a little bit, certainly on the penalty situation, for their jamming scoring. Buenos Diaz had 56. Not Naughty with 27. Crash Banshee-Coot with 25. And we are getting ready to go to Megatron with the post-game interview.
Hey, this is Megatron here at track number 2 at ECDX for WFTDA.TV. I'm with Dixie Kicks, the captain of Blue Ridge. How's it going?
Hi, I'm doing great.
Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
So you and Brandywine, you're 41 and 49 respectively. How did you prepare for this game specifically?
We just practiced and practiced and practiced. We have been turning the air conditioning off at our practice space to get used to practicing under difficult conditions. We have had several bouts in the last couple months we've had several away bouts. So we've definitely been practicing at different venues to prepare to come all the way up here to Pennsylvania.
Excellent. And in the second half, you guys held them to 42 points. It was a very different second half. What changed when you went into halftime?
You know, halftime is great. It's nice to have a little break and get riled up in the locker room. So we try not to say this, but recently we've been a second half team. So we've had a lot of tides scored recently, but then in the half we just come out swinging because we want to show everyone how great we are.
Excellent. You have Helsinki next. What are you looking forward to?
Oh, yeah. We're looking forward to that. We have played two bouts in one day recently, so we are trying to get prepared, and we're worked up, and we're ready to fight.
Now, my last question. With you guys being number 41 in the WFTDA, which do you prefer, being the top of D2, or do you want to move up and start fighting the fight in D1?
Oh, man. It's all about the climb. We definitely want to climb up, up, up the ladder. So we definitely want to try and aim for D1. So that's what we're going for.
Excellent. Well, congratulations on the win. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for more awesome action here at ECDX in Feasterville, Pennsylvania. I'm Megatron for WFTDA.TV.
Hi, Mom.
I switched to the Falcon Plus plate, which is a 16-degree angle.
The fact that you can adjust so many different aspects of the plate really means that I can adjust it to my skating style.
I feel like the plate is giving me that extra agility, but at the same time, I'm not losing any energy in my push.
Since moving to the 16-degree, I've felt that I've got so much power and the action is so much quicker.
I've been skating on them for about 4 months now, and my edge work has improved, my control has improved.
Prior to this, I found that the plates were very obvious on my feet and I knew that I was wearing skates, whereas now they all feel part of my leg, like they've just grown on there.
With all the practice, work, fight, sweat, tears. To achieve the next level, it takes a team. Rose City's Wheels of Justice present Derby Days, a badass boot camp. 3 days of skills, drills, and scrimmages coached by Portland's all-stars and special guest. The Wheels of Justice Derby Days. Registration opens June 1st.